Greetings. Greetings. It's Bill, the Taizy guy. And today we're going to talk a little bit about a couple things. First, we're going to talk about some arm exercises and some hand exercises and some balance exercises. So, much of this is just traditional Chinese exercise stuff with Tai Chi and Qigong and things like that. So the first one we're going to do is the teacup exercises. It's like you have teacups in your hand and you want to keep the teacups upright. So basically it's like have the teacups out in front, bring them back behind, get close to the body, back behind, up and around, and back in front. And we do this with the breath. The toes are always straight ahead. So it's easier to keep the back straight when the toes are straight ahead. So we want to do this, toes straight ahead here. And the knees are always bent slightly, they're not locked. We always keep the knees bent slightly so the energy can flow through into the body. So here we're going to bring the teacups in toward the body and then back, sort of pass them back behind. And then around the outside, lift up, take a nice deep breath, inhale here. Expand the abdomen as you inhale. And as you come, bring the hands around to the sides and out in front again, you're going to exhale and bend forward slightly. Make sure the toes are straight ahead here. Exhale, inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Now, the slower you do this, you'll feel more tone in the muscles. You want to always control the gravity here. We're controlling the gravity so that we go through a range of movement controlling the gravity. Okay? As we control the gravity, we get a little more tone in the muscles. The energy goes through the muscles and the arms as well. Now we're going to do what we call the butterflies. The butterflies are simply moving the hands, like flicking water off your hands as fast as you can. So basically, teacups with the butterflies. Inhale, nice deep abdominal breath. Exhale, forward, toes straight ahead. Remember, back straight, tuck the chin in slightly. Inhale, nice deep abdominal breath. Exhale, forward. Okay, so that's the teacups with the breath. And the butterflies. So, next one is the exaggerated walking. Now, it's like you're walking. You're just twisting. Loosening up here, walking. Now what we're going to do, we're going to start to control the gravity now. Controlling the gravity. Nice tone in the muscles here. And then what we're going to do is bring your hands all the way up and touch. And then control the gravity back down the opposite direction. So it's like you're walking. Hands come all the way up, touch, and then back down the opposite direction. So once again, all the way up and back down. And we're going to do it with the butterflies, remember? Flicking the water off the hands as fast as you can. So walking, flicking, butterflies, controlling your gravity. And so once again, we do it slowly. Doesn't seem like much of an exercise, but if you do this slowly for a few minutes, you'll start to feel the tone. And then you can continually go one way and then switch back the other way. Sets of three are always good, 3, 6, 9s. And then we also like to finish in the neutral stance. Check the posture, like your pile of sand now, bag of sand, you're settling. All the muscles are sort of evenly balanced here. It's always a good idea to balance the active exercise with the static exercise. Make sure your back is straight here. Just settling. All the muscles are balancing out. Spine is straight. Focus on the Dan Tien, center of gravity in the body. Where is it? These are the parts you'll be moving from when we do the next exercise. The Dan Tien, center of gravity in the body. So from here, what we're going to do is we're going to do the Tai Chi walking. So the Tai Chi walking starts out with the feet shoulder distance apart. Bring that foot straight back. Down from the shoulder, straight back. So from here, what we're going to do is shift back, turn to the left slightly, bring the left toe up, back straight again, tuck the chin in. We have a plumb line from our ear. We want to have a nice, we're going to go right down the spine here, nice and straight. If you're forward, it puts excess stress on a certain part of the spine. So we want to have the back straight so the stress is evenly distributed. The integrity of the back muscles help keep the spine straight. Okay, so from here, we're going to shift back, turn to the left slightly, shift forward, step forward with the right. Remember, back straight here. Step forward, 45 degree angle with the right. Shift forward, back straight. Tuck the chin, lift the top of the head. Shift back, turn to the left, or turn to the right. Step in with the left. Shift forward. So this is basically the essence of the Tai Chi walking. We're isolating the step so that we don't have a forward momentum. What happens is if you have a forward momentum, you're more likely to, if the front foot has a slips on something, you're more likely to go forward. So what we're doing is we're practicing isolating these muscles. And so Dr. Paul Lam, a Tai Chi expert, has done research on this. You might want to check him out. Dr. Paul Lam. And they found that people who practice the Tai Chi walking exercise and or Tai Chi have less falls. So it's helped save money for the medical expenses in some countries. And they sponsor these types of events. So once again, the Tai Chi walking review, quick review. Shoulder distance apart, 45 degree angle. And so we're gonna shift back, turn to the left, shift forward. Now for you advanced students who want a little challenge, bring that leg up and just bring it up there and hold it up there for a while. Make sure your back is straight here. And then sink just a little bit more. And then reach out with that heel. And then shift forward. And then shift back. Turn to the right slightly. Step forward. Sink and reach. Shift forward. Back. Step forward. So that's the Tai Chi walking. It's basically isolating the balance basically on one leg before you shift into the next leg. So this prevents the forward momentum of walking, and that therefore you have better balance. So thanks for watching. If you'd like to get a hold of me, you can contact me at healthsaversforyou@gmail.com. I teach classes up here in Northern California. You can also call me to do seminars if you'd like. 707-445-1599.